My husband, 33, male, and I, 26, female, got married 1 year ago, and it's been a relatively happy marriage. We fight sometimes, but it's nothing unlike the fights that other married couples usually have, and we always make up within a day or two, so I don't think he's unhappy with me or anything of the sort. I met him through a friend at a party 3 years ago, and we got to talking, and eventually he asked me out. I'd just gotten out of a relationship at the time, so I waited a few weeks before saying yes to him. But eventually, I did, and we hit it off within the first few dates. Before we'd even hit the 3 month mark of the relationship, I'd introduced him to my parents and moved in with him because the timing just felt right. And I never felt like he wasn't okay with it either, since I asked him multiple times if things were going too fast for him. But he always told me that it was perfect the way it is. Anyway, eventually we got married, and just last week we celebrated our first anniversary. I planned the whole thing and rented out our favorite restaurant, threw an extravagant party with all our friends and family, and even made a mixtape of all his favorite songs, since he'd always talk about how he used to love those as a teenager. So yeah, I pretty much pulled out all the stops for our anniversary and did my best to surprise him. I'm a working woman as well, so I also decided to foot the bill all by myself, as this was my anniversary gift to my husband. He got me a lovely pair of diamond studs that he gave to me the night of the party, right after we got home. But he didn't seem too enthusiastic about it and looked like he just wanted the day to be done with. It was kind of weird, but I didn't think much of it and chalked it up to exhaustion from the party and went to sleep without worrying too much about it. Even then, the next day, his behavior didn't change and he seemed even more on edge than the night before. He snapped at me when I served him breakfast because I'd drawn a heart on his toast with jam and told me that he'd not even asked for jam, which seemed really odd to me. I decided to ask him about his behavior a few minutes after he'd finished breakfast, because his snapping at me had almost made me cry, since I'd only wanted to do a sweet thing. I sat him down afterward and explained to him that since last night, I could sense that there was something off about his behavior. And even today, he'd snapped at me about something unnecessary. So I wanted him to talk to me about what exactly had been bothering him and if I could do anything to fix it. I'd assumed that it would probably be something work-related, but he completely blindsided me by saying that it was actually me and my behavior that made him feel like he was being smothered, and my grand gestures that I thought were sweet made it impossible to reciprocate the amount of love and effort I was putting into our marriage. I didn't understand what the problem was, because I obviously didn't think he should go all out for me like that always as well. I was completely all right with him doing little things for me, like those earrings which I'd mentioned I'd liked and he'd remembered. I was quite taken aback, since he seemed to have had a good time at the party yesterday, and I had no idea that he'd been feeling this way. I told him that I could dial down the romance or whatever if that's what he wanted, but he still didn't like that and said that he needed more space and a little time to cope with things. He said that he regretted rushing things in the initial stages of our relationship, and now he felt suffocated because of how attached I was to him. Honestly, I don't think of myself as a clingy woman, because I have a job and spend most of the day outside my house just like he does, and neither are we one of those couples who are attached at the hip. We lead independent, separate lives and hang out with our friends, go out by ourselves sometimes, and try not to smother each other. This didn't make sense to me. And then he dropped another bomb on me. He told me that he wanted to open up our relationship and try something different. He added that I shouldn't take this the wrong way, and that while he still does love me, he wants us both to experience everything else as well, so that we don't resent each other in the future. I was stunned and didn't even know what to say to that. I'd never even considered being with anyone else, because That's how loyal I was to him. Maybe these open relationships would work for other people, but not me. And I was so hurt that he was even suggesting it. After I overcame my initial shock, I told him that we could try marriage counseling to fix things, but an open relationship seemed a little extreme and unnecessary. But he was being very stubborn and told me that in his opinion, it was only an open relationship that could make him feel less smothered by me, and it might even do me some good to talk to other people. We got into a huge fight over that, and it ended with me sobbing about how he didn't love me anymore, and him accusing me of trying to manipulate him and guilt-tripping him by crying. Obviously, that really hurt me, and I spent the next 2 days avoiding him. I even worked late nights just so that I wouldn't have to speak to him when I came back home, and neither did he try to talk to me either. On the third day, which was yesterday, we finally spoke since it was the weekend and both of us happened to be at home. He's the one who approached me and said that he wanted to discuss our relationship a little more calmly than we had the other day. I thought he would take everything back and apologize for whatever he said, but instead, he doubled down on his stance on us needing to open up our marriage. He told me that he did love and respect me like he'd always done, but he also wanted to see what was out there for him since he'd only ever been in two serious relationships before I came along. He even reminded me that I'd had several flings and a couple of relationships before him, so I'd lived my life to the fullest, and he was just asking for the same. Naturally, on hearing all of this, I felt like crying again. But more than that, I was just really upset that he was using my own past against me to advocate for an open marriage despite knowing how against it I was and how much that would hurt me. I felt hurt, angry, and betrayed that he would say all of this and expect me to understand and agree with all of it as well. He just went on speaking about how it would do us both a world of good and could even fix our relationship forever, so that we'd never have weird issues like this ever again. So eventually, I agreed and said that we'd download dating apps right then and there. He seemed a little surprised and said that I could take some more time, but I was just done with this conversation. I told him that we needed to do this quickly since this was what he believed would fix our relationship. Not that I was even aware that our relationship needed fixing. He agreed and a little reluctantly since he was the one who'd been trying to convince me to do this in the first place. So I decided to go to my study and create a profile on 3 dating apps purely out of spite and nothing else. I had no intention of getting with anyone or, hell, even responding to any texts. I was just fueled by anger while making my profile and wanted to teach my husband a lesson, that's all. So I picked my most attractive pictures and tried to be as charming and cute while answering the prompts. Within 15 minutes, I'd created 3 dating profiles on 3 separate apps and started swiping. And in the next hour or so, I did nothing but swipe right for every guy. Like I said earlier, I was fueled by my rage and hurt. So even though I knew it was a complete waste of my time and energy, I still went through with it. I'm an attractive woman and I know that, so it wasn't surprising to me when the likes hit almost 600 within half an hour of me creating the accounts. And I already had at least 70 matches waiting for me on all the accounts combined. I'd been petty enough to pay for the premium versions as well so that I'd have unlimited swipes in a day. We didn't talk much for the rest of the day and he seemed to be busy on his phone as well. I felt awful watching him use his phone and ignoring me altogether, and even considered the possibility of him already cheating on me and using this as an opportunity to go ahead with that. But I just didn't say anything because I was feeling spiteful and mean. So I waited until this morning and decided to casually bring up the dating apps with my husband. I asked him at breakfast if he had matched with anyone and he said that he hadn't. And then he asked me if I had, and that's when I brought out my phone and handed it to him, telling him to see for himself. It felt like I'd won the Nobel or something when I watched his face turn scarlet and he actually pushed his bowl of cereal away, saying he didn't feel like eating anymore after checking my phone. It felt like a huge win for me, since now he knew that he'd failed to get even a single woman to match with him, while I had over 100 men waiting for me to respond. I had no idea what was going to happen next, but I was feeling really over the moon with this revelation and was in no mood to let this go so quickly. So after a while, when my husband came up to me and apologized, saying that we needed to delete these dating profiles and he was ready to go back to normal, I decided to decline. I know it's petty, but the amount of anger and pain I've been dealing with ever since he first brought up the whole open relationship thing needed an outlet. So I did whatever felt right in that moment. I said I wasn't going to delete anything since now I wanted to open our relationship up and experience something new. Obviously, I was messing with him and just wanted to get back at him for whatever had happened in these past 2 days. He looked appalled and started arguing with me, saying that I'd been so against it in the beginning, so it didn't make sense for me to switch over so quickly. I said that all those matches had made me realize how desirable I was, and if he didn't value me, then I should probably find someone who did. He then started lecturing me about how most of these men are creeps and just want to hook up with me without any emotional relationship, and I said that I was fine with that and told him that it was too late now and I'd made up my mind to remain active on these apps. That's when he started crying and practically begged me to delete the apps, saying that he'd made a mistake and wanted nothing but to fix our relationship now. I was kind of taken aback and didn't know how to respond, so I stayed silent for a while and he continued to cry. I felt horrible about whatever was happening and wasn't enjoying it so much anymore, but also, I just didn't know what to say. Eventually, he went to his room saying that he needed to lay down and told me in his most resigned voice that I was free to do whatever I wanted to, but he'd be waiting for me nevertheless. It's been a couple of hours since and he's fallen asleep, but I can tell that he was really distressed. I also know that he wouldn't have reacted the same way had he also matched with someone. Now, I don't know how to feel about this whole situation. I feel awful and guilty, but a small part of me also feels like he deserves this. I feel like I might be the bad guy for dragging this out, but then it was all really painful for me as well. So now AITA for refusing to delete the dating apps on my phone after he insisted on having an open marriage and ended up with zero matches? Update 1. He woke up a couple of minutes ago, but instead of coming to me, he left the house without a word. I even tried to stop him and called out his name, but he didn't respond. I tried to call him as well, but he didn't answer and merely texted back saying that he needed some time to clear his head after whatever he'd gone through. I'm really confused right now because what does he even mean by that? He's not gone through even half of what he put me through these past few days, and I simply only gave him a test of his own medicine. That's it. I'm obviously still not in a good mood, and I'm pretty freaking upset about this whole debacle, but I still want to talk things through and sort it all out with him. But if he's going to act like a sulky, immature child, pretending like I've wronged him or whatever, then I don't know what I'm going to do. I'm just really fed up with his behavior right now, and I'm beginning to regret throwing that huge party on our anniversary in the first place, since that's the day all of this began. I guess I'll just have to wait for him to come back home and see what happens. Update 2. I'd thought about apologizing to him and getting it over with, but by the time he came back home, I just didn't feel very sorry anymore. He came back home at around midnight yesterday, completely sloshed, and had to be carried inside by his friends. I'd waited up for him to return and fallen asleep on the couch in itself, so it was a bit of a shock for me as well. His friends told me that they'd asked him if he'd want to join them for drinks and dinner earlier, but he just said no and then turned up unexpectedly. They also mentioned that They tried to stop him from drinking so much, but he'd snapped at them and said that how much he drank was none of their business, so they didn't push it further since they could sense that he was clearly going through something. I thanked them for helping him out and bringing him home safely, and then even helped them put him to bed and slept on the couch myself. I was hurt, confused and annoyed the entire night and barely even slept because of how bizarrely my husband was behaving. I wanted to speak to him this morning, but he's terribly hungover and I don't think it's the right time. Besides, I myself am in desperate need of some sleep and rest, so I've taken a day off to stay at home and give myself a break. We haven't spoken yet, but he's made himself a smoothie and is still in bed with an ice pack on his forehead and I'm still on the couch. I feel more and more annoyed about his behavior with every passing second, but I know if I act rashly, then it'll just lead to another fight, and I absolutely don't want that to happen. So I'm just going to wait for him to speak to me first, and then, well, I don't know what I'll talk to him about anyway, but I'm surely not approaching him first. Update 3. Around half an hour ago in the evening, we finally talked. I'd woken up from a long nap and he also looked less tired. He was sitting opposite me on his recliner and reading when I woke up, and as soon as he noticed that my eyes were open, he got up and kissed my forehead. I was a little disorientated because, like I said, I'd just woken up and was struggling to make sense of what he was trying to do. Before I could ask him anything, he left to go to the kitchen. In the meantime, I deleted all the dating apps from my phone. I hadn't even opened those after our big fight, and at this point, it just felt unnecessarily cruel to still keep them and use them against my husband when he was clearly struggling with something serious. I waited for him to come back to speak to me, and within minutes he was there with a mug of coffee and my favorite cookies for me. I waited for him to start talking since this sudden change in his behavior was sort of freaking me out. And after I'd had my first sip, he said that he was sorry about everything. He apologized to me for acting so irrationally and about the whole open relationship thing as well, and told me that he truly, genuinely didn't mean it, and it was just him being an insecure idiot. And that's when he finally told me about why exactly he'd been behaving so strangely after the party. So at the restaurant, he overheard one of my friend's wives from college gossiping about how I used to be with a distant cousin of mine. Neither of them is particularly close to me, so it wasn't surprising to me that they'd been talking crap about me. My friend's wife had attended a different college, but she knew me since we ran in the same circles back then, and they'd been discussing how I was always hanging out with boys and having flings left and right in college. They made it seem like I was getting with new guys every other day, and that made him feel kind of weird because I'd never told him about any of those things, and my version of my college life seemed pretty tame. Then they said something even worse, and that got to him since it was about him. My husband's never been an insecure guy, but if there's one thing that he doesn't like people talking about or making fun of, it's his weight. He's had to struggle with his body image since he was in middle school because obesity runs in his family, and so he used to be paranoid that he might gain too much weight. So he would actively avoid eating much, and that led to him becoming extremely malnourished and sickly later on. And while he has recovered from that, he's not very well built and is still relatively thin compared to other guys. My friend's wife and her cousin were snickering about how they'd ever expected me to end up with some skinny old loser taking a dig at my husband's age and body both, which just totally messed him up. He confessed that while he'd tried to ignore it and go back to having fun, he just felt insecure and not good enough for me because he felt that I was way too good for him and he didn't deserve me. And when he failed to get any likes on the dating apps, that just proved his worst fears to be true. He told me that he didn't blame me for whatever I did since he knew that the way he'd been behaving was irrational and just totally unacceptable, and even said that he would understand if I wanted to leave since what he did was just crazy and stupid. But He apologized sincerely for his behavior, and when, in spite of everything, I still took care of him the way I always do, he knew that I was in with him for the long run, and nothing else mattered to me other than being happy with each other. By the time he got to say that, both of us were in tears, and he seemed really ashamed of whatever he'd said and done. He told me that there was nothing more that he wanted than to stay with me and work things out because he really was sorry about hurting me, but he'd also understand if I wanted to leave. I told him that he needed to do nothing of the sort because I wasn't going anywhere, and even though I was extremely upset about how he'd behaved, I knew that he wasn't like that, and it was just his insecurities that overcame him. He admitted that he shouldn't have paid any mind to whatever those two idiots were gossiping about and should have just told me everything from the get-go instead of trying to suffer in silence and making things so needlessly complicated. After a lot of crying, we finally made up. But obviously, we still have a lot to work on, and we've decided to go for marriage counseling to make sure things like this don't happen in the future again. I really do love my husband, and I couldn't care less about whether he's skinny or old or whatever. I love him the way he is, and he doesn't need to change a thing. I've blocked those two women who had been gossiping about my husband so shamelessly at an event that I'd hosted. My husband has also decided to go to therapy himself to deal with his own esteem issues, and I'm hoping that it helps. I know he loves me and would never intentionally do anything to hurt me this way again. And I know marriage is tough, but I want to stick it out with him because I think he's worth all of the trouble. Update 4. So it's been around 2 months since the last update, and while I know a lot of people aren't going to be happy about the fact that we decided to stay together, it still worked out well for us, so we have no complaints. Both of us have learned a lot about ourselves and each other in therapy, and I'm hoping that we continue to learn and grow together. And in even better news, we're also expecting our first child. I'm 6 weeks in, and we found out almost 3 weeks ago. It's been kind of weird since then, but it's a good kind of weird. My husband has already bought like 10 books or something and has taken it upon himself to treat me like a queen. I like it though, and I could get used to this every day because right now I'm not allowed to do any household chores since my husband insists on doing it all himself and reads to the baby at night before we go to sleep. We've practically forgotten and moved on from that incident in the past, and I know I made the right choice by staying with this man. Stay tuned for more stories from Our Girl Relationships.